We're spending money to deal with this. So Chris Brown and Drake are being sued. But apparently someone thinks that Chris Brown and Drake stole their song. I'm gonna make a very simple comparison and briefly explain why I think this is bogus. Shout out to the wonderful Melanin Monroe, who actually created the video I'm gonna be watching and kind of giving my thoughts on, just so that you guys can get a little bit more context. Thank you, Melanin Monroe. But let's talk about the music, shall we?
Chris Brown and Drake are allegedly being sued for stealing the song No Guidance.
Okay, so let's get some context. What is No Guidance? You got it, girl, you got it. That's all that you need to know about the song in order to get this lawsuit. Let's look more at it, shall we?
A claim was filed by a man named Brandon Cooper and Timothy Valentine are suing Chris Brown and Drake for claiming No Guidance ripped off their work on a track called
Ripped Off. When we're talking about music, we're talking about, especially when you're talking what you hear on the radio, you're not really hearing much more than the major scale, right? So usually you're gonna get melodies that are moving up in stepwise motion, or you're gonna get melodies that move in skips. With rhythm, you can get a little bit more, you can get more out of it. Because music, or at least Western music, has a 700 year history. If you go all the way back to Renaissance music, quoting musicians was a normal thing, and nobody was ever laying hold of the copyright. The concepts of copywriting melodies is really, really new. For someone to say that someone ripped off someone else's stuff, it's gotta be like blatant. Now, if it's a genuine ripoff, if it's like word for word, note for note, rhythm for rhythm, then I'm like, okay, yeah, whatever. But ripped off is a really strong phrase.
Valentine claimed an analysis of the beats, lyrics, hook, and rhythmic.
Okay, wait. An analysis of the beat, lyrics, hook, rhythmic structure is what's determining this. Let's do a little bit of an analysis, shall we? Okay, the track's called I Love Your Dress. Let's look at just lyrics, because apparently this analysis deduces that these songs are similar. Nobody in the world compares to you. You turn heads every time you step into a room. I bet they say to themselves, she got it, she got it, she got it. I'm assuming that the similarity is in the you got it part. First of all, you got it is a popular phrase, and it's also three words. The likelihood of people, you know, getting there, you know, on their own, very likely. Now let's take a look at No Guidance. The only real similarity I'm really seeing is the you got it, girl. Okay, let's analyze the melody, because with this analysis, we're looking at beats, rhythmic structure, lyric, and hook. So let's look at this hook. Let's analyze this melodically. Okay, so that's what we got here. You got it, girl, you got it. So we got 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Already, I'm getting some red flags, because this is the major scale. Mi, re, do. To make a claim on something like this is even harder. At least in my brain, in the court of law that is O'Neal Gerald Donald, the major scale is such a cornerstone of musical composition. You can't just say, oh yeah, you stole my stuff. That wasn't your stuff to begin with. It was the major scale. Adam Neely, a wonderful music theorist and YouTuber, actually talked about Katy Perry's song when it got sued against, and he kind of went in a lot more detail than I'm going. But essentially, yeah, let's not. Anyway, you can't copyright the alphabet. That's essentially what you're doing when you're saying that you're copying the major scale. But a lot of these people that are doing this jurisdiction and stuff, like, they're not necessarily music theorists. Not even just music theorists, but musicians in general. And so they're not necessarily taking this from a musical standpoint, which is really dumb. Now, I love your dress. Okay, so let's look at this you got it part.
She got it, she got it. She got it, she got it.
No, they're not similar at all. You got it, you got it, you got it. And it's not even really rhythmically confined to the beat. It's kind of doing its own thing. You got it, you got it, you got it. They have the same notes. The songs are in the same key, and that's probably why you might want to draw some type of similarity. The rhythms are different. It's, and he's doing 3-2-2 and versus 3-2-1. I'm already out here. No. Even the tempos, everything, the songs aren't similar at all. But here's my zhuzh. We're spending money to deal with this. This is ridiculous. They're not similar. This is actually a waste of time. Conversations about musical similarities doesn't need to lead into a lawsuit. Even if there was a true case here, we don't need to be getting into ownership when it comes to music. Now, we've already created copyright systems. We've already created copyright laws that I personally, as a composer and a musician, have problems with because it doesn't free up people to actually write the way that they want to write. But let's not waste time, guys. But one thing that wouldn't be a waste of time is getting your voice right, especially if you have been losing your voice for a long time. I'm a vocal coach. I'm a music teacher. This is the most awkward segue ever. But anyway, what does make sense is you, if you are a professional singer, if you are a singer that is on stage every week and you have been losing your voice, and if you have been performing and you haven't had the stage confidence as you think as you should have, I encourage you to actually watch my free masterclass at reclaimyourvoice.ca/masterclass, because that is some really good information and is not a waste of your time. I am not giving more energy to this. This just kind of ticked me off and I'm just kind of popping in. But yeah, guys, let's do better. I'm O'Neill Gerald Donald. Subscribe to this channel if you're new. I'll see you later.